All right, just waiting for people to show up. Kind of amazing coincidences going around how it's absolutely fascinating to me, the Truman world that I live in. Like, there's no doubt, like, how can this not be a Truman world? Like, I sat around waiting for my live stream capabilities forever. And after sitting around and sitting around and sitting around going, how come I'm not getting my live stream capabilities? What is going on with this? So I jump on to the whole YouTube help forums and I find out this is an ongoing issue. And people all the way back from 2020 still hadn't been able to live stream. And it's ongoing. They just won't allow these streams through. So I did a video last night posting, just the screenshot of look at this, I can't believe it. It looks like they're phasing out live streams. And I was just flabbergasted because they're like, man, this is a big deal. Then the very next day, my live stream started. The weird coincidences in life, right? Like, I want to chalk it up to coincidence, but I'm finding it hard these days with coincidences. So it's just very strange that all of this being held back. I put up a video and then the very next day, boom, I got it. So anyway, I'll take it because I want to get this stuff going. The reason why I'm going back to live streams and I can't wait to get back to live streams is every video I make seems to be gets messed up during translation when I upload now. So like I'll do the video and it takes a long time to narrate the videos with a mic and sit there as opposed to live stream where I can just talk about it and not worry about what I'm saying and I can just put it out there where then I take it and I upload it and then they offset the screens or the slides don't work or any of that kind of stuff. So I'm happy to get that back. And so understanding that the last video that if you watched where I went over the government failing, the government collapsing, halfway through that, or even depending on the time, it seemed like it lost it. So all the slides kind of got blurred up and just didn't work well. So I'm going to redo that information because it's pretty important. There seems to be a pretty good message hidden within this event and the fact that the event itself is completely made up as well. So all that other stuff, interesting as it goes. But as far as this, let's get to it. Okay. So, the Afghan government collapses. The Taliban enters Kabul. Now, this is a pretty big story. It's going around the world. The whole g government has to pull out. So, what do we get? Let's take a look at a little bit of history to set the stage here. Tisha B'Av and 9/11. That day of destruction happened on 11/9, the ninth day of the Hebrew month. Or the ninth day of the Hebrew month of Av, which is the 11th month, the ninth of Av, the 9/11. Now, this is referring to the two temples. Now, Tisha B'Av, the first temple was destroyed on Tisha B'Av, apparently, and so was the second temple, the first by the Babylonians in 586, and the second by the Romans in 70 AD. So the two temples being destroyed, both on Tisha B'Av, which is on the civic calendar of the Hebrew calendar on the 9th of Av, the 9/11. So on 9/11, they have the saddest day in their calendar where they m remember the temples, the two temples. Now, it's interesting because Solomon began to build the house of the Lord and he set up the pillars in the porch of the temple and called the name thereof Jachin and Boaz. And these two temples, these two towers, Jachin and Boaz, are situated in every Mason hall as the pinnacle posts that hold up and sustain all things. Now, when we take a look at 9/11 being Tisha B'Av, being the Hebrew date, so when we see 9/11 being Tisha B'Av, remembering 9/11, the twin towers, we can see the symbolism of the two towers. The twin towers of Jachin and Boaz being also symbolized in the Temple of Solomon itself and Herod's temple and the 9/11 associated to both going down. So we've been through this many times before. And now it's interesting how it all comes full circle, because now here we have the Taliban says the US must stick to its 9/11 exit date, but we will not attack them. The spokesperson cites the Trump's administration's agreement to withdraw and reiterates that we are committed not to attack as US troops carry out these evacuations. And the fact is, with all the 9/11 stuff connected to what's going on and Tisha B'Av and all this stuff, just the fact that the US Air Force plane is 9/11 or 1109 is just enough on its own. However, when we take a look more into this, that 1109, well, 8101 is the 1109th prime. And in 2019, the 811 was Tisha B'Av as well. And on that day, a twin typhoon took place. So we get the Twin Towers, we get the Two Towers, and we get the twin typhoons all on Tisha B'Av. And the result was 28 dead with 1 million evacuated when the typhoon actually made landfall in China on August 11th, which was Tisha B'Av on the Hebrew calendar. Now, 8/11 was an interesting date because it was the 223rd day of the year. And we're familiar with the association to the Georgia Guidestones and to the depopulation that's associated to that number. Revelation also adds to this coding system with, "And I will kill her children, and I will give unto every one of you according to your works." And it's all about depopulation with the mantra of maintain humanity under 500 million. And now this isn't a new thing, and we've been talking about how old this is. And this clip is pretty fascinating because it goes all the way back to 1973, which is 7 years earlier than the Guidestones. But it shows that this idea, this concept, this plan of depopulation has been around for a very, very long time.
Decades, there will be 7 billion human beings on this planet. Most of them brown, yellow, or black. All of them hungry. All of them determined to love. They'll swarm out of their breeding grounds into Europe and North America. Hence Vietnam. An all-out effort there will give us control of South Asia for decades to come. And with proper planning, we can reduce the population to 550 million by the end of the century. I know. I've seen the data.
So all the way back in 1973, they were looking at depopulation down to 550 million, just like the 322 Guidestones.
Not doing it will be catastrophic. We'll have 8 degrees, we'll be 8 degrees hotter in 10, not 10, but in 30 or 40 years, and basically none of the crops will grow. Most of the people will have died, and the rest of us will be cannibals. Civilization will have broken down. What the few people who are left will be living in a failed state like Somalia or Sudan, and living conditions will be intolerable. The droughts will be so bad there'll be no more corn growing. Not doing it is suicide, just like dropping bombs on each other, nuclear weapons is suicide. So we've got to stop doing the two suicidal things, which are hanging on to our nuclear weapons.
And global
overreach. And then after that, we've got to stabilize the population. When I was born, there was
so what's wrong with the population? I mean,
with too many people. That's why we have global warming. We have global warming because too many people are using too much stuff.
But
if there were less people, they'd be using less stuff.
If there were less people, they'd be using less stuff. The mantra hasn't ended. The plan hasn't gone away. It's just getting bigger, and it's upon us. And we can see the continuation of this plan as all the study we've been doing up to this point. So the Afghan government collapses. So the government collapses. Now we know that this situation, so when we take a look at this, we get these interesting signals. On the plane, it says 11/9, right? So 11/09. Well, when we take a look at this, that could be a date. And so when I did, October 19th gives us a 119. The 1109 could give us November 9th. Now, When I take a look at October 19th, however, it's the seven leaves 73 days left in the year, just like that video we saw where they explained the Depop was in 1973. Well, the 73 is the 21st prime, so it's a number they themselves like to associate to this event. And we can see the 9/11 is associated to it, the 73, which gives us the 21st prime, which again is the sixth triangular number. When we double that, we get the 66th triangular number at 2211, which continues its pattern to the 666 with the 222 and 111, and it just keeps going on. So when we get to 9/11 being the 1120 prime, we can see how that day of 73 being the starting of this whole thing, and itself being a 9/11, it's all very, very perfect for their numbers. And that's why I think the date of October 9th is 19th is going to be the next big kind of event turning point in the storyline. We're building up to something. And when we take the date of August 11th, 2019, which was Tisha B'Av, to October 19th, the day of interest, it's exactly 2211, the 66th triangular number. When we take a good look from the coronavirus being declared a pandemic to October 19th, it's 1222. When we take a look at it in months, weeks, and days, we get a 1911 embedded right in. So instead of years and days, well, even months, weeks, and days gives us a 1911, a 9/11. What's also interesting is in year, months, weeks, and days, we get the 1711. And that's another big number. Why? Because that's when COVID was announced to have been discovered on November 17th with patient zero. And this information was given to us on March 13th. So the 1117 was when patient zero took place. And even running the date of March 11th, we get that embedded in that same numerical algorithm. And there all these numbers are sticking together in this depopulation conversation. And the fact that this information was released on March 13th, the 313, that's very significant. So when we go from this date of when the patient zero was found October 19th, we get another 1112. So we get in this one line of dates, we get all the important numbers, the 9/11, the 8/11, the 7/11s, the 2222, 111s, and it's all connected within itself. Even the date that they released the information about patient zero was on a 313, March 13th, 313. And this Taliban, meet the Taliban's elite commando unit, the Badri 313. So even the Taliban is reacting in a 313. We've been over the absolute use of this number along this strategic timeline. And we've identified some very big 313s already. That's when Constantine came into power and legalized Christianity. JFK was killed on the Zapruder film on frame 313. And don't forget that he was killed on the 11/22, just like we saw in the date encoding up into the coming October 19th. We also know that on the 313, the pandemic and all has preparedness reauthorization act of 2013 was signed law by Obama, which makes what they're doing in the states right now legal. And it was, of course, introduced on the 811, which is the Tisha B'Av number. We also see that Pope Francis was elected into power on the 313 in 2013, the exact same day this was put into power, passed the House with Amendment 122. Trump declared the national emergency on the 313. 313 is the 65th prime. George Floyd was 65. And when we ran October 18th, Event 201, the 118, 2019, when we run Event 201 to May 25th, Floyd's death, it's the 313. And it's a fascinating exactly 220 days, which is a 22 and a 7 months and 7 days, 77. Huge numbers in this study, 22, 77, and a 313. Even from November 11th, 1918, World War I, to October 19th, 2021, and all the other ones did it too, but we can only keep these videos so long. Every major thing going on in Satan's timeline plan is carrying these numbers. When we take a look at that and we run from World War I and land it on October 19th, 2021, our day of interest, we get 102 years, 11 months, and 8 days. So we get an 811 and a 201, which just happens again to be when Event 201 took place, 118. So we get both the 201 and the 118 when we run the World War I date. And don't forget that Jesus foretold the Tisha B'Av event. In Matthew 24, and Jesus went out and departed from the temple, and Jesus said unto them, "See not all these things? Verily I say unto you, there shall not be left here one stone upon another that shall not be thrown down." Well, this is a big deal because of the numerological significance applied to Jesus. For Jesus was killed on a cube at the age of 33 as a human and blood sacrifice. And human and blood sacrifice are 86 and 68. And we know that these numbers are significant in this world to these people because it's even drifted into our common language.
Take it off, Joe!
Take the menu off the menu.
86 it!
86 it. 86 that human and blood sacrifice Jesus of 33, who I said was killed on a cube. Which is 77, just like the date stamp between 8/11 and with the 313 span to George Floyd's death. It's also interesting that 3003 is the 77th triangular number. So a 33 associated to the death of a man on a cube, which is numerically a 77, and it just also happens to be the 77th triangular number is a 33. Considering that we have academics now arguing that Jesus would have died on the 3rd at 3 p.m. in 33. It's interesting how they play these games because we can take, you know, Mr. Biden, Mr. Joe, the, you know, part of the 111222 algorithm's birthday, November 20th, 1120. It was 333 days. What's also interesting is when we go back to this number, 9/11 is the 11/20th prime. 9/11 is the 11/20th prime. 9/11 is Joe Biden's birthday. And when we run Joe Biden's birthday, the 9/11 of the 11/20, it's 333 days. Which we understand is very important because they've embedded this message in February 2nd, 2020, which was the 2222, which was the day of the Super Bowl, and a very interesting numerical date because of the leap year, which made it the 33rd day of the year and with 333 days remaining in the year. And it was a very special day, for they announced the rising of the Phoenix. So they declared the beginning of chaos, order out of chaos, with the Phoenix rising in Super Bowl 2020. And they even signified and told us how through putting people in cages to sing about it. When we take the date of that Super Bowl and we run it to October 19th, 2021, we get that all too familiar 223 or 322. So why is this 33 so significant? And why does it wrap into all of this? The streak is snapped. Bradley and Bridgeport have both moved to 33 degrees Fahrenheit on a 14-day stretch of freezing cold. 33 degrees, 14-day stretch. Well, 14 is 7 plus 7. So there we have the 77th triangular number. 3003 is the 77th. It's all connected. But why is it now plastered all over the news? The Scottish Rite of Freemasonry, the Supreme Council 33 degrees of the Southern Jurisdiction of the USA. They explain it for us. To understand the power and the authority of the 33. The Supreme Council at Charleston was the first Supreme Council of the 33 degree in the world. It continues to exist today as the Supreme Council 33 degree Southern Jurisdiction. However, it was moved to Washington, D.C. in 1870 and now sits at the House of the Temple as the premier Supreme Council. It naturally exercised authority over the entire country. Isn't it interesting, these numbers and how they associate their meanings to it? On Amazon, on the music, they gave us 33 hertz gamma waves, which is the Christ consciousness frequencies, which are connected to the sacred geometry worship in the pyramid and even reflects the low frequency emissions of the Schumann resonance. The 33rd hertz Christ consciousness put up for sale on 33 in 2016. Drop the 0 to 16 and 6 times 6 times 6. John 3:2. The same came to Jesus saying, "We know thou art a teacher come from God." And 33 just happens to be the master teacher number. Number 33 is a master number, the master teacher number, and it is a combination of the two master numbers, 11 and 22. The 11 spheres of the tree of life combined with the 22 paths of the tree of life, equaling the 33, the 33rd spiritual perfection, or the third tower of the Masonic belief system.
22 goes to 33.
As we sort through this here in Arkansas, today we have 33 confirmed positive cases in Arkansas.
As of today, we have 33 confirmed cases with Boston residents. We expect those numbers to climb.
As is this afternoon, we have 33 Pennsylvanians who have tested positive for COVID-19.
So as of this morning, there were 33 cases in North Carolina.
Good evening to you. Lots to get to tonight. I'm Leon Hendricks. We want to start with new information into our newsroom. Within the past couple of hours, there are now 33 confirmed cases of the coronavirus in Michigan.
That is 33 new cases from just yesterday.
Good afternoon, I'm Karen Swenson. More cases and more events affected. Here is the latest coronavirus news. There are now 33 cases in Louisiana. As expected. The number of cases of COVID-19 jumps. A total of 33.
As the premier Supreme Council, it naturally exercised authority over the entire country. You think they would have given that up? The 33 is the supreme authority, and all of their constituents were signing on to the program and letting them know the message has been heard. They're doing what they're told to do. They're following suit. And the 33 is the stamp that seals their participation. They're following orders and telling everybody around them in one simple statement. 33. The United Nations, who happen to have a symbol that takes the entire earth and divides it up into 33 districts. On each side, we have 13 and 13 leaves of the laurel leaves, which is the 26th letter alphabet, the one world language, all sitting upon the seat of authority, the Supreme Council of 33. In ancient Roman religion, Victoria was the goddess of victory, often depicted crowning gods and emperors with laurel wreaths in her hands. The coins of Octavius Augustus to coins from the time of Constantine the Great, emperors were portrayed with a laurel wreath on their head. In ancient times, the laurel wreath, made from interwoven leaves of the bay laurel plant, was worn on the heads of emperors to signify imperial power and authority. It has endured for a millennia as one of the defining symbols of ancient Rome and continues to be used to today. As head of the Roman Catholic Church, the Pope is the supreme spiritual leader of the church and controls the church doctrine. As the supreme council, it naturally exercised authority over the entire country. And now that they have taken control of the entire country, they went and put the health symbol on top of it. The WHO's emblem was chosen by the first World Health Assembly in 1948. The serpent. And the great dragon was cast out, that old serpent called the devil and Satan. And of course, they did it in 1948 because 223 is the 48th prime. It's all connected. The numbers never stop, and they're the same numbers. They're always the same numbers. The time of the Holocaust, 1933. In 322, in March 22nd, the concentration camps open. On March 3rd, on the 33, Jewish doctors barred from practicing medicine in German institutions. Revelation 12:4, and his tail drew a third part of the stars from heaven. A third part of the stars. One divided by three, a third is 33, 3, 3, 3, 3. And behold, a great red dragon. The great red dragon is 137, which is the 33rd prime. And now you know why they consider the 33 to be the supreme authority. And that's why when we see Kabul and Afghans trying to flee, on August 16th at 8:11 p.m., 16 is 8 plus 8, we get our 888s, we get our 8:11, the Wall Street Journal. And what do we get on August 16th? We get it leaving 137 days in the year, the 33rd prime. And the plane that they were all, that the government collapsed with was 1109, which is 1 plus 1 plus 9 is 11. 6-2 is 8, 4 plus 4 plus 6 is 14, and the 9-11 plane is 33. On 8-16, the Great Red Dragon, 137, the 33rd prime, on August 16th, at leaving 137 days in the year, 33rd prime. With a plane drafted in an 1109-33. The laurel leaves of the Roman Empire, cradled by the Nazi eagle, and continued on in the United States eagle. I have learned most of all from the Jesuit order so far, there has been nothing more imposing on earth than the hierarchical organization of the Catholic Church. A good part of that organization I have transported direct to my own party. The Vatican crest. The great dragon. And they never even gave us the courtesy of using a real plane. The whole thing is so overblown, it's unbelievable. The actual aircraft would look like this, with actual windows. And the model, the actual symbols, the entrance, you know, like the access points that aren't even on this plane, like they don't even exist. Blacked out rubber windows, not actual windows. They're military dummies. which are decoys and are intended to deceive the enemy. During World War II, dummy airfields and even towns were used in England to divert German bombers from real targets. At the Battle of the La Ciotat, however you say it, in 1944, the American aircraft dropped hundreds of dummy paratroopers. The goal was to divert German troops away from the real landing zones of Operation Dragoon. Additionally, World War II Operation Quicksilver was an attempt to mislead Germans to the location of the D-Day invasion using dummy military equipment. And if you really want, you can go buy some. You can get inflatable defense units for training shelters and more. Even inflatable health tents. All available at this one company in the U.S., veteran-owned. Inflatable F-2 Raptor jets, you know, exact duplicate of the F-22. I guess people just randomly want these in their front yards. According to the I2K defense, they are able to make tanks, vehicles, aircrafts. We've been creating full-scale inflatables for over 25 years right here in the United States. Our expertise enables us to customize replicas for all military machineries. I2K Defense can design and manufacture inflatable tanks, transport vehicles, and other military equipment that matches any required specifications. Just enter your military email address to gain access. It's a fake. So that means the 9/11/33 warning is not even about the Taliban. It's not. It's about a different event. And I believe that event to be October 9th. They're celebrating the 33. They're celebrating the October 9th. Again, it could be November 9th, but there is a lot of heavy significance pointing to October 9th as well. So, that's not got caught up in play in the balloons.
Time he has a trump card. His secret services have assembled a phantom army. Codename, Operation Fortitude. To misdirect German reconnaissance units, thousands of inflatable vehicles of all types are deployed near Dover to make it look like a landing in the Pas-de-Calais. Codename, Operation Fortitude. To misdirect German reconnaissance units, thousands of inflatable vehicles of all types are deployed near Dover to make it look like a landing in the Pas-de-Calais.
It's weird how it has no tires. Where's the front wheel? It's weird. Why are they all covering up where the wheels are? Look at that. Guess they don't want you to see there isn't any. I really want to take one sec here, and I really appreciate you guys that are doing the support for the contributions you have given. It really helps us out. We too are being greatly affected by the times changing. You've heard multiple times my wife is in healthcare, so our income is about to stop here right away. And so we really do appreciate everyone who has given either through Patreon or through PayPal or any way that we've actually received in multiple ways. And we just really appreciate the fact that you guys have, like what I'm doing here, and that you have helped us, because it really appreciate it. And I just want to put out there again, if you do appreciate and like what I'm doing here, we are more than willing to accept anything that you would like to give, especially during these times. We just greatly appreciate it. And that being said, I want to point out, there is a lot of stuff going on right now, and we are at the beginning of this huge event. Everything that's been building up is now transpiring. We're going to start seeing exactly what we've been tracking. The fall of the U.S., North America is going to go, the entire Commonwealth is already transforming into militarized zones. We're already seeing war talk. We've got the weather warfare really ramped up. everything that we've talked about is happening. The two things that are left on the table that's going to decentralize the or disassemble the whole thing is the financial situation crashing and the coming famine of the food shortages. Places all over are reporting lack of food and they're pretending like it's not there. We're going to wake up with a day with nothing. And I don't know if a lot of you get that. I know a lot of you are trying to figure out what's going on and there's a lot of stress and a lot of trying to just, but a lot of you aren't doing anything about it. It's not time to do it. It was time to do it. You have very little opportunity left to get food. And if you really want to wait and see, I don't understand it anymore. Take everything you have, sell it. If it is not going to provide you with rent, your mortgage, food, water, and your own power, then get rid of it. Because without that, you're going to have to sign on to their system. You're going to have to. I don't know how I'm going to get around it. We're so close to it, we don't even know how it's going to unfold. Nobody knows what's coming down the pipe. That's why we need God more than ever. And we need, through Jesus Christ, to come to an understanding and be good with where we're at now, knowing that God, through Jesus, will do what he needs to do. And we're okay with that. I know the people who understand what I'm saying will get it. We're okay with whatever God decides. But God will do what he needs to do. And if that's takes care of you, then he'll take care of you. That is a relationship that you can develop with God that I can't describe and explain to you. And people who don't understand that won't understand it. But Jesus has become the realization for me that God is not the God of the dead. He is the God of the living. And in Jesus, we see not only the actual physical resurrection, but through him, the living relationship. And when you walk with Jesus and your life becomes supernatural and the things that you need fall into your lap 1 second before they're needed, even when you didn't know they were coming, and it's an event after event after event of his love manifesting in your life simply because you're calling out for help, you will know the truth. God is not the God of the dead. He has not the promises of the future. He is living and reigning and ruling now. We are administrators. We walk this earth knowing that God has Jesus sat down on his right hand. The judgment has been done. He is victorious. It is not coming. He is already victorious. So let them scramble and let them fret, for they know they're running out of time. And this is their only last ditch effort. They're not winning, people. They're doing this because they're losing. The time is short, but not because of what you read in the newspapers or what because the religion is telling you. The time is short because the truth is upon us. Wherever you are, I hope this finds you well. God bless.